Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha. Today we are going to discuss a very contemporary and a crucial topic, that is COVID-19 penal provision for enforcing social distancing. Why I have selected this topic? Because as you all know, this is a very contemporary topic and the world is facing this problem. We all are posting many messages, many important information pertaining to COVID-19 in many social medias like Facebook and WhatsApp and so on. But I think many persons are not taking it seriously, which is a demand of present situation. In this particular video, I'll explain not only the meaning of COVID-19, but also the penal provisions pertaining to enforce social distance. Please take it seriously and listen properly. Now let's discuss this problem in detail. As you all know that WHO has declared COVID-19 as a pandemic on 11th March 2020. Now what is pandemic? It is basically an epidemic that has spread worldwide, affecting a large number of people. The Union Government of India has invoked the powers under Epidemic Disease Act 1897 to enhance preparedness and containment of the virus and declared COVID-19 a notified disaster under the Disaster Management Act 2005. Furthermore, to prevent the transmission of COVID-19 pandemic, the Union Government has invoked the powers under Epidemic Act 1987 and Disaster Management Act 2005 to declare 21 days countrywide lockdown. As a precautionary measure, district magistrates have imposed prohibitory orders under Section 144 of Code of Criminal Procedure 1973 in several districts to curb the transmission. That was the only intention. Now, the penal provisions for pandemic in India. There are four types of penal provisions pertaining to pandemic in India. The first one is Epidemic Disease Act 1897, in which COVID-19 has been declared as a pandemic. Second is Disaster Management Act 2005, where any sort of disaster is managed. Third is Criminal Procedure Code 1973. Criminal Procedure Code 1973, as I said, that district magistrate has ordered Section 144 in every district. So it comes under this also. And if anyone violates Section 144 of CRPC, he is punished under Section 188 of IPC also. So Indian Penal Code Section 188 is also part of the penal provisions. And other than Section 188, there are three more sections which is also related to pandemic penal provision for pandemic in India. That is Section 269, 270 and 271. Now, first is the Disaster Management Act 2005. Precisely, the object and purpose of the Act are to manage disasters, including preparation of mitigation strategies, capacity building and more. This is the basic object of this act. A disaster is usually associated with a natural calamity such as a cyclone or earthquake or so on. Even the definition of the disaster in Section 2D of the Disaster Management Act states that a disaster means a catastrophe, mishap, calamity or grave occurrence in any area arising from natural or man-made causes. And in India, the central government has included COVID-19 flare-up as a disaster, as a critical medical condition or pandemic situation. Secondly, the Epidemic Disease Act 1897, which states that the central government as well as the state government have the power to take special measures and prescribe regulation to prevent the spread of a dangerous epidemic disease. Again, point out to prevent the spread of a dangerous epidemic disease. That means if any person is violating this, again, there is a penalty of disobeying any regulation or order made under this Act shall be deemed to have committed an offence punishable under Section 188 of the Indian Penal Code 1860. That means other than Section 144 of CRPC, even if any person is violating the provision pertaining to this Act, will also be punished under Section 188 of Indian Penal Code 1860. Now the third point, that is Section 144 of CRPC, which states power to issue an order in urgent case of nuisance of apprehended danger. This is very important because commonly and usually people are confused Section 144 as curfew, whereas both are different. I will make a separate video on the difference between the Section 144 and curfew. This particular video and in this particular PPT, I'll explain Section 144 precisely because this is very lengthy and you need to know only pertaining to COVID-19. So, District Magistrate has the power to issue an order in urgent cases of a nuisance of apprehended danger. If we consider that such direction is likely to prevent or tend to prevent obstruction, annoyance, or injury to any person lawfully employed, or danger to human life, health or safety, or a disturbance of the public tranquility or a right of an affray. That means it is clear that it is an order in urgent case of nuisance of apprehended danger. Now that apprehended danger can be divided into two parts. The first part is any danger pertaining to obstruction, annoyance, public tranquility or a right affray, etc. Second is a danger to human life, health or safety. If we talk about the COVID-19, it is related to the apprehended danger to human life, health or safety. Second point, it does not admit of the serving of due time of a notice upon the person against whom the order is directed, be passed ex parte. Third, it imposes restriction on the personal liberty of individual, specific locality, or in the entire town. In COVID-19, it is on the entire town, not only the town, but on the nation. Fourth, no order under this section shall remain in force for more than 2 months from the making thereof. There cannot be more than 2 months of that order, provided if the state government considered it necessary so to do after assessment of the situation by the district administration. That means if district administration feels that the problem still persists, it may extend. Otherwise, this type of order will extend only for 2 months. And the last one is any magistrate may rescind or alter any order made under this section if situation required. If there is an urgency and a need, they may or the district magistrate may alter the order. Now the provisions under IPC. The first one is Section 188. It is very simple. Whoever violates Section 144 of CRPC will be punished under Section 188 of Indian Penal Code. That means disobedience to order duly promulgated by public servant. Whoever knowing that by an order promulgated by a public servant lawfully empowered to promulgate such order, he is directed to abstain from a certain act or to take certain order with certain property in this position or under his management, disobey such direction, shall, if such disobedience causes or tend to cause obstruction, annoyance or injury or risk of obstruction, annoyance or injury to any person lawfully employed, be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 month or with fine which may extend to 200 rupees or with both. And if such disobedience causes or tends to cause danger to human life, health or safety or cause or tend to cause a riot or affray shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 6 months or with fine which may extend to 1,000 rupees or with both. Here section 188 is also divided into two parts. As we have discussed section 144, it states that that is also divided into two parts. One part is related with the disturbance or disobedience of the public tranquility. If there is a problem pertaining to that, the violation of section 144, then the punishment may be 1 month. But as far as COVID-19 is concerned, it has been specially mentioned that if there is any danger to human life, health or safety, then a person may be punished for 6 months and a fine which may extend to 1,000 rupees or both. There are some more provisions under IPC pertaining to pandemic. First is section 269 of Indian Penal Code, which is negligent act likely to spread infection of disease dangerous to life. Second is section 270 of Indian Penal Code. Then section 271 of Indian Penal Code. Now section 269 of the Indian Penal Code, which means negligent act likely to spread infection of disease dangerous to life, which states that whoever unlawfully or negligently does any act which is known or has reason to believe to be likely to spread the infection of any disease dangerous to life shall be punished and imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 6 months or with fine or with both. That means it has been clearly stated that if the person is suffering from such disease which can spread infection, he will be liable for the punishment of 6 months or a fine or both. Second is section 270. That means malignant act likely to spread infection of disease dangerous to life. Whoever malignantly does any act which he knows or has reason to believe to be likely to spread the infection of any disease dangerous to life shall be punished with imprisonment either description for a term which may extend to 2 years or with fine or both. This is much serious because here the person is aware about the disease and he is intentionally spreading that disease. And if the person does so, he will be punished for 2 years or fine or both. And lastly, that is section 271 of Indian Penal Code, which states disobedience of quarantine rule. Whoever knowingly disobeys any rule made and promulgated by the government for putting any vessel into a state of quarantine or for regulate the intercourse of vessel in a state of quarantine with the shore or with such vessel or for regulating the intercourse between places where an infectious disease prevails and other places shall be punished with the imprisonment of either description for the term may extend to 6 months or fine or with both. That means this is also very serious. If there is a disobedience of quarantine rule, the person may be punished for 6 months or fine or both. So please take it seriously. This is all about the penal provision enforcing to social distancing pertaining to COVID-19. I hope you like the video and also understand the legality, seriousness and necessity of present scenario. If you really want to support police, doctors, nurses, administration, yourself, your family, nation and world, please stay at home and stay safe. This is very precise video. If you want a detailed note, you may also follow me on my website That is priyasapaha.com. Follow us on FB page, that is Law College Q, Instagram Law College Q, and Twitter Dr. Priya Sepaha. Thank you for watching. I hope you like it. Do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.